Hello, everybody. So I'm here in the StreamEye event office along with all our friends and all our beta users. And right now we are announcing the public commercial release of Holographics version 1. I'm totally not used to this, so this is like, hello. I'm going to talk you through a few things because we thought it would be better not to just let this moment pass. So we're going to talk you through kind of the early beginnings of Holographics, what we've been doing, and what's coming up next. So I'm going to talk you through this presentation. So Holographics, it was born out of a frustrating, dire need. This, as you can see, is the current state of broadcast graphics. There is some good stuff out there. There's some bad stuff out there. But the issue we ran into, being a live streaming company, is that there is nothing that really does the basics very well. And so we figured that's something we need to tackle. So this is kind of what you get if you Google broadcast graphics. And I personally don't get so super excited about it. And the funny thing is that everything kind of about live stream production is getting cheaper, and it's getting more open, and there's open source software, and there is really cool kind of movements happening, and live graphics is lagging behind. There's nothing, there's no real progress happening in that area, and so we thought, let's tackle that with our own solution. You can also see the business models used by the big commercial parties, they're very traditional. It's all reseller-based. You have high prices. If you want to just buy a piece of software and use it right away, it's just not possible. It's you have to go through some reseller system, contact sales, get a quote. They want to look at the application you have for it, and it's a hassle. So whatever solution we would come up with, it would have to be something you can just download and use instantly. If you need an additional license for it, it shouldn't really take you more than three clicks to upgrade. And then the operation part of it's stuff is just too complicated. You need special operators. You need special hardware usually, and this hardware is not cheap. It runs into the tens of thousands of euros. It requires, in order to create some kind of custom graphic package, it might take you days. It might take a team days to put together. And that's just, you know, for the type of projects we would do, live stream projects, online streaming, it's just not applicable. You want to come in without anything prepared and just be ready to go in 10 minutes. And the last thing I want to mention about this is, again, the standard templates. They will not win any awards. So we wanted to come up with something that allows really powerful, easy styling really quickly. So that was our mission. Let's do really basic graphics, but do them really well. We're not yet ready to go and do the very complicated stuff like sports or very you know, important 3D things with augmented reality and virtual reality and all that. We're just going to do the really basic stuff, and we're going to do it really well. So back in 2016, we were looking at technologies, and one thing that you can see is web technology. It's getting better. And it's getting better fast. So in the last 20 years, we went from web 1.0 to what you see on the right here. And you can have full 3D graphics, complicated animations, whatever you can imagine, you can build it on web technology these days. There's canvases, which allows drawing of 3D graphics. There is animation and video. So web technology as a whole kind of evolved into becoming this platform for really good applications. And so we decided, let's build something that makes use of this technology and kind of bring the two worlds together, something that's evolving really fast and something that's evolving really slowly, the video broadcast industry. So that's what we did. why not build a web-based system for broadcast graphics? And so there we went, and here we are on the first prototype back in 2016, publicly released on the CaspersCG forums and on GitHub. You can see we just had a clock and we just had some messages, and it worked. It was flabbergasting that this would actually work the way we thought it would. And so that was version zero, and this was the user interface. And then, so you can see there's just a clock and there's a lower third, and it's either there or it's not there, and there's kind of nothing in between. And so this is not just one part of the application. This was the application. There was nothing else. So that was version zero, the first prototype. And it forced you to download this raw JavaScript thing, and you had to have some runtime environment for it, and it was a bit of a hassle. So then we went with version 0.2 a bit later. And this sort of era of holographics, it allowed it to be a standard application. We would have automatic updates, so whenever we would come up with new features, they would get implemented kind of automagically. And we had widgets and themes. Now, it wasn't very flexible. You could only have one piece of text or one clock, for example. But we did have themes, and the themes was a kind of a stepping stone, because now you can select a theme that kind of suits your liking. You can put in the variables relevant to whatever you're doing that day. So let's say that you have a project for some big client and you want their brand color and their brand logo to be visible. You just put in that information and then it's there. It will just render, it will adjust the theme based on those on that input and control your output. So the thing we decided is this needs to be so simple to set up and so simple to use that it's never left behind. It can be operated by someone who is not very technical, and it does not require any special hardware to be used. So it just needs to run on basically any desktop computer. And what we've seen for our productions is that this really turned out well. This piece of software, it runs on anything. It runs on a Raspberry Pi. It runs on any laptop. You can just start it up, and you can have your HTML browser window, and you can use it to render graphics in real time. And we never leave home without it. Even if we don't use it, it's there. And if our client asks us, and they say, well, I need some lower third, or I need some information on screen, it's not really a problem, because it's there anyway. And it's so quick to set up, it just takes a moment. It comes with a bunch of default themes, which are crisp, they're clean, and they render in HTML, which means that whatever resolution you're working with, it's always sharp. It's always it's always crisp. And even if you go 8K, and we haven't really tested this, because we don't have an 8K screen. But even if you go 8K, it should just work. And that's part of the power of HTML. You know, it's vector-based graphics. There's nothing bitmap about it. And it's going to scale to whatever you're doing. So you have default themes that are not bad. You can adjust your colors to go in any direction with that theme. And you can go custom themes. So you can use the full power of the web technologies we're using, CSS, to kind of create your own theme and go full on power mode with that. And there's live editing, which is just magical, in my opinion. You just type, and whatever you're adjusting, it shows up live on your render view. And you can really be creative with it. So that was holographics from version 0.2, and it's simple functionality, and it will just work. There's no bells, there's no bells and whistles. It's just the basics, and the basics really well. So then we went public beta, and this was received quite well. This is a photo from one of our users. And it proved the concept. So it's a good concept. We need to do more with it. We had workflows for professionals and smaller users alike. We personally use it a lot with vMix. But I've seen people use it with CaspRCG. It's possible now with the latest builds of Open Broadcaster Studio to do decklink output for Blackmagic devices with key and fill. And so you can do key and fill output if that's what you need, or you can just have an HTML page at your disposal and put that full screen on a Chromecast, or you can use it as a browser layer on your OBS or your vMix and use that to overlay directly on top of your screen. So it's applications for professionals and smaller users alike. And today, we are announcing version 1. which actually, this is a screenshot from this morning at 6:30 a.m. When it was finally there, finally ready. And so I pushed that out on the auto update system, and then I went to bed. And I slept through until about 1 this today. So version 1, and so much has changed. It's like, when we realized the potential here, we realized we had to redo some stuff. Because the interface was a bit slow and some possibilities that we wanted, they just weren't possible. So version 1 is almost entirely rebuilt from the ground up. The user interface has been completely redone. Nothing about it is what you've seen in the old version. And what that means for you is that if you use Holographics, it's going to feel a lot faster. If you click around in it, the application is going to respond instantly. We just have a lot more options with the user interface. So you'll feel in using it that some things, they respond. Like if something's not possible, you'll get the feedback immediately. There's a little thing in the upper right corner that tells you if information is coming in or if information has been going out. It's just responsive. It's nice. And the big feature that we're launching today as well is custom widgets. So previously we had custom themes. You could adjust the themes that that you had, but now you can also create your custom widgets. The thing is, it's a little bit of a complicated feature, and there's no documentation for it just yet. So I might be creating a lot of trouble for myself by putting this out there. But if you go into your user folder, which you can access through the application, there is a folder with widgets, and these are all the default widgets included. You can go in and tinker with them. So that should provide a kind of a stepping stone for the people that want to get started with that until we get the time to write that documentation and make it a fully available feature. But the kind of stuff, I mean, the feature, the widget system has also been redone from the ground up, and that makes a lot of really cool stuff possible. So we're also launching a couple new default widgets today. One of them is the YouTube widget. It does pretty much what you would think it does, which is you put in a link and it shows you the video. And you can choose whether or not it loops. And it's pretty handy. I used it today to do an audio sync test. Just load a video from YouTube and it's on there. It works. Obviously, memes are a possibility. So you select your aspect ratio. You can select whether or not it should be looping. And then you hit show. You can adjust the position and size and the window around it and everything. And it's just the way you'd expect. And the other cool thing is the particle widget. So we are including a particle widget in the latest version. And it's kind of magical. I can quickly pull it up here because I had a demo for it. So it's hard to see maybe on the stream, but there's a bunch of particles in the background and they kind of move in an organic, pleasant canvas of backgroundness, and it's really we're going to use this in so many of our streams just to provide a, you know, just before you go live, you want to kind of say, well, live stream starting soon. Well, you put on the particle widget. It's funny and nifty and cool. Not to mention, you can do snow with it. So today we had some people cancel today because it's snowing, and so you can do snow with your particle widget. The other big thing is you can now have multiple widgets of the same type. So previously, you could only have one of any widget. So we'd have a broadcast widget, and that'd just be it. And now you can do more than one broadcast widget. You can do more than one YouTube widget, and you just add and remove them, and you can play with them, and you give them names, and it's cool. So that's Holographics 1.0. It's available today. You can download it right now, or if you open up your installed version of Holographics, it will automatically update. And there's change logs now, so you'll be able to see kind of what's new in the latest version, so I'll be using that. And the other thing is, today we are announcing our pricing model, because as you know, we've been working on Holographics for a really long time, and it's been a public beta for a long time, and we feel that right now we're at a point where we're kind of ready to say, well, this is a commercial piece of software. It's a it's a piece of kit. We've been using it for our own productions. We can almost no longer live without it. And so it's time to go commercial. And today we're announcing our pricing model with the side note that until February 14th, it's going to be free for everybody, and you can use it as much as you want. The main reason for that is we didn't finish our store in time. So that's your benefit. And I'm going to go hard at work coding the store feature, and then we'll get you buying Holographics soon. So the pricing, there's a couple things about it. The thing that annoyed us most about all the other software packages that are available is it's first of all, it's hard to purchase, it's expensive, and it's not flexible. So the things we wanted to provide were it needs to be really quick to upgrade or downgrade. If you need it for just one project, you should be able to just do that. And we want the price to be so low that it's available to everybody. And so we're going to be playing around with that, most likely. We have a formula now that we have arrived at with some talks with our beta users. And we're not sure if it's the definitive thing. But for now, we're launching with this, and it's very likely that there will be additional pricing models in the future. So there will be a free version. It's going to be publicly available, downloadable from the website. We're going to change the sign-up form, so you don't have to leave your email address to get the download link, because that was a bit of an annoyance for some. So we're giving the download away for free. So if you're at a production and you need lower thirds or messages or whatever, and you need it now, you can do that. You can just go to the website, click download, and it's going to just work. But we're limiting it, and we're limiting it to one active widget. So you can only have one lower third, for example, in your project and active at once. And we're limiting it to 10 data entries. So that means that if you have, for example, 10 names that you want to toggle between in your lower third, that's the maximum. So we think that's a good compromise. We want to give some stuff away for free so that it becomes a tool set for everybody. But at the same time, we need to be able to continue affording development. So therein lies the pro version, which is going to be a monthly fee. It's going to be a subscription-based system. Put in your credit card, and you can tick the amount of licenses that you need. It's going to be 40 euros a month, or it's going to be 240 euros if paid yearly. So we want to kind of get people to sign up for the yearly version, because obviously you don't have to renew every month, and it's cheaper. But we understand that for some it's necessary to have some flexibility. At the same time, if you already have a yearly license, but it's not enough, you need more seats or something like that, you can just very quickly, within the application, you'll be able to just say, I want one or two additional licenses for 1 month, and it will just charge to your credit card, and it will not be a hassle. So it will be very quick to get, very quick to downgrade. Additionally, we're announcing early bird pricing, because we feel that even though we're out of beta, we're not just totally out of beta. We feel that we need to be thankful to everybody that's been with us for all this time. So we're gonna do early bird pricing. So within 2019, we'll have lowered prices. It's going to be 20 euro per month. and it's going to be 200 euros if paid yearly. So it's a bit lower from the other prices. I'm done. Thank you, everybody. So if there's any questions from the live stream now, I'm able to answer those. If not, we're shutting down. Any questions? We're good. Okay.
Questions from here?
Questions from the room? Well,
a
deafening silence. We're going to have some beers and we're going to start a barbecue. Oh, there's champagne coming. Oh, leer. Oh, that moet ik vasthouden. Ja, precies. Okay, this we didn't rehearse this. Oh, boy. Oh, yeah.
They're not official champagne glasses, but...
So, it's barbecue time.
Cheers, man.
Cheers.
Congrats.
To a good software application.